Bowling Show is proudly presented by your local ABPA, Gold Pin and AMF Tenpin Bowling Centres.
Hello everybody and welcome to the Tenpin Bowling Show's telecast of the VIC 150 tournament from AMF Keon Park Lanes in Melbourne. Joining me in commentary is Michael Tran. Good evening, Michael.
Good evening, Brenton.
Yes, this is a very different type of tournament. It's a ladies' tournament. We don't see too many on the Tenpin Bowling Show, but it's a doubles tournament with a bit of a twist. It's a pro-am type format. We have normal handicap league type bowlers bowling with open bowlers who play the tournament circuit on a regular basis. It makes for a very interesting format, Michael.
Yeah, absolutely. It gives the handicap bowlers just a little bit of experience, going into events like this, bowling on more competitive patterns with more competitive bowlers, and it's more of an experience, I think, I feel. Yeah.
Absolutely it is. Yeah. Anyway, here we are with our first match. We have Sarah Benson and Melissa Thompson, who have a 28 handicap. They're up against Emily Robertson and Shirley Muxworthy, who will be playing with a 25 handicap.
So let's go through a bit more of the format here, Brenton. Basically, the bowlers have thrown X amount of games to start with to determine their qualifying start.
That's right, they've had 16 games worth of qualifying over 2 days, 8-game blocks. The graded players have bowled with the open grade players right through the whole tournament. Then your top 12 teams, are determined on their finishing positions.
Okay, and to my belief, the first scratch bowler takes on with them the 12th finishing graded bowler, the second and the 11th, and so on until we have our 12 teams.
We've done that way to try and even the field up a little bit. As you'll notice, though, that especially with the type of bowling pattern that they've laid down here at Keon Park Lanes over this Easter, even some of the graded players are scoring quite high and then throwing some pretty good looking shots. Here's Emily Robertson, one of the few left-handers you'll see, and with one hand, what a swing. Nice shot.
Yeah, beautiful strike there. So covered a lot of boards for that shot, and flush on the 1-2 for the lefty, carrying the 10 very nicely.
Yeah, she's still quite deep, just a little bit left, swung it out towards the gutter, and that's quite a good shot. See the scores up in the top corner there, they'll be updating on every shot. And Shirley Muxworthy with a crossover strike there to go with her first frame spin.
Okay, Melissa Thompson going into the pocket there and leaving a 5-pin.
Notice that in most cases the graded players are throwing straighter angles and not as much rotation as you'd probably expect from people who are in the main just normal league bowlers. It's a tournament that gives them the chance to test out their skills with some of the best female players in the country.
Now, what an excellent opportunity it is to line up against the likes of your Emily Robertsons and your Anne-Marie Putneys of the world. That would just be fantastic.
Absolutely. Imagine getting a chance to bowl with the current World Cup champion.
Well, how about that?
Absolutely. It would be one of the person's greatest skills in mind, I suggest. Emily Robertson here. Made a good start. Saw the line. And that shot's looking really good, isn't it?
Yeah, that's an excellent shot. You can't fault that at all.
It looks like it's flat. Using actually the oil in the middle of the lane, swinging out to the dry part of the lane, it's coming out nicely. This is Sarah Benson, also from Victoria. A little bit straighter angle, a little bit more of a semi-spinner type release, but still looks pretty effective, doesn't it?
Yeah, same effect, isn't it? She's taking more of the direct approach to the pocket, and she seems to be getting a fair bit of rotation at the back end there, burying the pocket nicely. And Sarah Benson, as well as Emily Robertson, both your open bowlers without handicap. And we'll see how the two of them go.
now, Shirley Mutsworth, she's gone spare double. And as I was saying earlier, given the type of lane condition we put down, some of the rated bowlers look like they're shooting fairly comparable numbers with their Open compatriots.
And Melissa Thompson there, just missing the target bowl. She's kind of washing out. She's with the 1-2-4-10.
No, she's got some pretty, a fairly high ball speed, lots of forward roll. Really can't afford to get the pocket away. So she's good on that occasion.
We'll see how she goes with the spare, though. A little bit too much of the headpin. Oh, wow. Getting the headpin to kick it back off and take the 10.
See, the headpin got squeezed slightly between the ball and the back curtain there. The squeeze got ejected out into the 10 pin.
You don't see that too often, do you?
No, especially not from the women bowlers, because they don't generally have the ball speed to create that sort of reaction. But
look at Emily Robinson again, making that lost turkey there to start with.
Absolutely, you can watch here. The 4 pin does all the work. Bobbles around in the gutter, kicks out just enough for the head of it to tap out the 7. Sarah Benson now. That's high. A little bit high. Probably a hair fortunate just to leave the 4-7. She's easily left to slip there. However, she'll go with a straight ball here.
There's a chance for redemption. Like I said, that could have been a lot worse. Yes. Could have been left with the 4-6-9-10. That's what we call big four.
She's got the plastic ball, so she's got to go straight at it. Oh, there you go. So the thing that we're going cross lane with the plastic ball like that sometimes, there's always that little thought in the back of your mind that quite possibly, I don't want to miss it twice, so just guide it a little bit. And I think that might have been what happened there.
Yeah, it's unfortunate, just taking the other one pin there. So she's on double plus one. Plus eight, sorry. As we watch Mr. Thompson there. Good pop a shot.
Yeah, good pop a shot. Looks like, yep, ball's good, maybe just a hair high. But, yep, capped the 10 pin, didn't quite take it out. Shirley, pushing on for a game here. First, crossed over in a row. Didn't quite get the 6 out this time. We're looking, it's been a little bit tense, a little bit nervous, and why wouldn't you be a normal lead bowler? Oh, that's a bad mistake. I think there's, yeah, some of the rated players, you know, first time on TV, wouldn't be surprised if there's a few nerves there. But that's certainly a solid spare.
Yeah, it's a good spare there.
Opponent missing the spare, that sort of loosens you up a little bit, doesn't it?
Yeah, it just gives you that that little bit of breathing space. And Melissa and Sarah in quite a considerable amount of trouble already, unfortunately, in this game. Sarah throwing what looked like being a high pocket within the 6 pin.
Yeah, high hit, pretty much through the nose, nearly took the 6 pin out. And notice that Emily now looking for four bagger. She started really strong.
Yeah, Mr. Tiger left there by the looks of it. Ball called the friction part of the lane
too early.
Yeah,
it might have got down a little bit too early. Caught the friction early and that's a better spare there by Sarah.
Yeah, good spare.
The one thing, when you have a lot of ball in the middle lane and a lot of dry on the outside boards, quite often if you miss too far left too early, you can't stop the ball from getting the friction too early and hitting through the nose. And that's probably way you tend to miss more on the easy conditions rather than the tough conditions. If you miss outside, the ball's not going to make it up to the pocket. Whereas on this, you miss outside too early, it's going to look pretty big.
Shirley Mutsworthy, she's turned it on, isn't she? She's with her 25 pin handicap. She's left herself an 8 count.
Yep. Both these graded bowlers, they're quite nicely balanced at the line. They certainly don't look too out of place in this competition.
No, they're doing well. Like I said earlier, a bit of nerves in front of the cameras and all that kind of thing. The lane condition's probably not what they used to bowling on.
Yeah, well, probably not. Is it just...
Wow.
Yeah, well, that could be quite exciting for the second event, but it was good enough for the ACB and... Shirley's going along quite nicely.
Shirley moves on to 87 after 4 frames working on the spare. She's doing very very well.
Hard mistake there from Melissa Ripper's pair. She's made that one nicely.
Yeah, that's solid. Let's have a look. Nice solid balance at the foul line, going across the lane and making a lot of mistakes there.
Plenty of speed, took the hook out of play there. Emily certainly is, she's looked far and away the most impressive of the four at the moment. Nice hand position, nice rotation. When you trip the four line out like that, it usually tells you about good angle of entry, good ball speed.
Yeah, 6-8 for the lefties.
That's right. I should know that, I'm a lefty.
But no, she, like I said, she had the right hand position. It looked like the ball speed was just a little bit slow, ducking high, but yeah, lucky enough she was sitting out.
Well, Sarah, again, it looked to me like the ball speed was a bit soft that time. Looked like she was around the target. Might have missed her hair, right, but Melissa looked her hair soft at the ball speed. She had a go at it. Good try, very good try. At this point in the match, probably needed to have a go at the two, but it was already substantially behind.
Oh, wow, this pin's going everywhere for that one.
Have a look at this on the replay. Head pin goes behind the six pin. I reckon that might have been the two pin going in front of it.
Yeah, she's crossed over once again. But look, if you're going to have a go, you've got to have a go, don't you?
Oh, that's right. Absolutely.
First pin, six pin, let's see a solid spin.
Taking a lot of time over this one. No one has missed way inside. Look like on that again might have just tried to, you know, throw it a bit hard to try and take the hook out of the equation. As a result, she's getting a little bit of a tug.
I think the nerves are definitely a part of this match. A couple of the girls not used to being on camera. And, you know, taking that extra couple of seconds that you normally wouldn't may just be playing a part in, you know, the shot execution.
Oh, I think it certainly is. Yeah, held the oil line nicely on that one.
Yeah, that was a good shot. She shouldn't get too damn hard about that.
The only thing you might have heard of there might have been a little bit of ball speed. That's it. Surely for a 25 handicap bowler is sparing extremely solidly.
No, she's done well.
Done extremely well. And you know, with Emily stringing some strides together, they're in a very strong position at the moment. Sarah looks like she's just trying a bit hard at the moment. Like she's trying too hard to sort of, you know, help carry the team with her teammates struggling, and as a result, she's crying a considerable distance. Yeah, I won't say she missed the building, but it wasn't far from it.
No. Just watching how her hand release was on the plastic ball, it looked like she may have come around just a bit too much.
I think you might be right tonight.
Looking at Emily now. Oh, giving a carry on the 7 pin as well. She's going gangbusters.
That's a couple of 7 pins she's tapped out. And when you're tapping the 7 pin out like that off the half, three-quarter pocket hits, it just tells me that you've just got the ideal ball speed and the ideal angle of entry, and just everything's matching up really nicely.
Yeah, she's just got a little bit more margin for error than the other girls. But, oh, wow, Shirley putting in a brilliant pocket shot there for
that
a strike.
That'd be just about her best shot of the match there, right there. The partner's bowling well, she's gaining in confidence, and their opponents are struggling, so, you know, all of a sudden she's back in the pocket and feeling a whole lot better about this television experience.
Yeah, for sure. You put all of it together, like you said, you've got your opponents struggling, your scratch teammate is doing very well, only missed a pocket once, and Shirley herself is throwing very, very well. It makes for a good experience on the TV cameras.
Absolutely. And Melissa goes back, makes a tough score there. The 3-6-10, there's just so many ways you can go about missing that one. And you made a good stand there.
Yeah, for sure.
I make it feel much better about the way things are coming. Emily now is just, geez, that's just really nice. She's doing very well indeed. Got a good balance of the line. And might have just been in the oil a bit more on that shot.
Yeah.
That was
a
bit inside target.
She missed inside.
Yep.
And it just too late going into the roll. That's a reason for the half seven.
Yeah, Sarah, she's got to put a couple of good shots in. And what's that, a 9 pin?
Yes, it was a good shot.
Well, yeah, that's unlucky.
It is a tad unlucky. It might have been a board high. But, you know, another day, another game, you could quite reasonably expect to carry that one.
solid spare there from Emily.
Showing that not only can she throw spikes, she's a good solid spare shooter as well.
And that you need to be in this game too. It's not the strikes that make you get into spares, isn't it?
Well, you know, if someone once told me you make 10-9 spares in a row, you shoot a 190 game. You shoot a 190 game, you're going to be competitive in those times.
Yeah, for sure.
Here's Melissa now. Up in the 8th frame. They're almost pretty much out of this match already. Looking to make a good shot. And she does.
Great shot.
Again, that would be her best shot of the match as well.
She's hit a different target there.
Yes, and just maybe just a little bit softer ball speed. High pocket there for Shirley. In the forepin. And yeah, she's bowled extremely solid. You know, for someone with, you know, 25 handicaps, she's bowled very, very solid. That's a great shot by Shirley Benson.
Yeah, consolidation strike, I think. So the pressure's pretty much off at this stage.
Oh, the pressure's off, but pinfall carries over. You know, from match to match to determine the final positions. So you do need to try and maximize your time as much as possible. Otherwise, yeah, if you just, all right, match is lost, go and just throw throwaway shots, you're doing yourself out of possible a higher cash position later.
Yeah, dollars.
Absolutely. That's what it comes down to. It comes down to dollars.
Emily, we've seen most of the game and it's been brilliant. It's like that strike. It's a very solid shot. I just like the look of her shot at the moment. She's very solid at the line. She's a couple of shots have been sort of wayward of a target, but for the most part, she's done
very impressive. Look, very impressive indeed. And you don't see too many left-handers with that type of shape of shot, and I think it's one of the very bright things. She's fine by that.
Yeah, for sure. She plays a little bit deeper than most left-handers, doesn't she?
I'm sure she plays deeper than I do, that's right. Another Brooklyn strike there for Shirley.
Well, Shirley's shaking her head at that one.
Don't think she's that happy with it, but it's 10 in the bit.
And the high fives all around at the bat.
That was a good effort there from Melissa. It's a good-looking shot. Again, look at that.
Yeah, it's over the same line and same target as the last shot, but unfortunately just couldn't get the carry over to
it. I think for both Sarah and Melissa, the ball speed's been a bit too inconsistent. I mean, you can have plenty of area on the lane, but if your ball speed's not consistent, you're really not going to make good use of it.
And just take that way inside. Now, the 10-pin, well, in my view, being a right-hander is probably the hardest pin to hit in the game, but most of all the pins are for either left or right-handers, but it's one of those basics in the game that really needs to be polished before
well, it does need to be polished, because when you look at it, especially at this level, you're going to leave more corner pins than any other single pin, okay? So you need to be able to spare them.
That one, I think, was just a little bit lucky to carry through the 7. She's playing a little bit more through the orb.
Yeah, it was a bit more through the orb, but again, managed to tuck out the 7.
She got the carry factor about it.
That's right. Sarah on this one, again, just a hair high in the pocket. Most of her shots have been around about the mark. She hasn't had a lot of carry. And some of the single pins as well has pretty much been them to fairly significant loss from this first match.
Spare on the 9 pin and gets it. Well done, Sarah.
Yeah, you can see she's certainly trying to get 10 different rotation on the ball. You might just be over rotating her head, but you can see she's at least trying to get something on the ball.
Yeah, you can see probably just a little bit different body language between them, so Sarah and Shirley and Emily. The approaches to the pins are probably just a little bit more rigid, maybe just feeling the pressure just a little bit.
Quite possibly, yes. I mean, they're both Emily and Shirley. They look more relaxed when they start, haven't they? Shirley is like this.
Yeah.
And the game she's got going for 25 handicap. 25 handicap, really, it's quite phenomenal.
Yeah, and the old without the handicap, her average would probably be in the 170s. But looks well on the way to a T20 game at the moment. She's doing fantastically well.
Oh, and the sort of confidence this gives your scratch partner. If you've got a handicap partner that's throwing these sort of games, it just helps loosen the swing up. Not well balanced on that one, but 10 in the pit again.
That's a carry factor for the team, I think. But she'd looked down at the foul line straight away and knew she missed the target.
Yeah.
And Melissa, on the other hand, going high for an 8 count, leaving the 6 and the 10.
Yeah. Melissa doesn't do too much wrong, except the swing gets away from her body. She's coming through the release point. There's a bit of a hole between her ankle and the ball. If she could fix that up, she'd become a much better bowler. Shirley, on the other hand, probably...
You can see her head there at the foul line. It does not move. The eyes are fixed on the target the whole way through.
Absolutely. And again, for 25 handicapper, she is remarkably solid. Sarah now looking to finish out.
Just looking to find something for the next game. And a lot of next time carries out the 17 for a strike. Just something, anything to take into the next game, I think Sarah's looking for, yeah.
Oh, look, if you can finish off well, as I said, your pinfall carries over. And not only that, you're looking, trying to throw some good shots to give yourself some confidence for the next match.
Emily, on the other hand,
she doesn't need to find any confidence. She is absolutely locked in.
She's fine.
Shirley, having shot 225 with a 25 handicap, that is a net 250.
Puts you in a good position, doesn't it?
Puts you in a great position. And Emily, if she can strike out, that would be a 257 game for a net 507.
Fantastic, isn't it?
That is huge. That's huge scoring, even on an easy condition. You know, you've got a hand it to both these girls. They've made all their spares. You know, they've taken every advantage of the problems that Sarah and Melissa have had. Kind of symptomatic of what happened there with Sarah missing that single pin. She's missed a couple of single pins for the match, a couple of other spares. It's really put them behind the eight ball. And Emily, she's just in dead strike.
She can't miss at the moment.
Oh,
that's all it comes down to, really.
Exactly. But not being able to miss, if you haven't got the, you know, the ball speed, the layout on the floor, the hand position, all that absolutely spot on, you're not going to get the sort of carry that she's been getting.
Yeah, you still have to have the fundamentals right to put together a good game.
And you watch it from here, solid at the line,
very
stays down nicely. 10 on the pit, thank you very much for a 257 game for Emily Robertson. That is a very, very good game. Final score, net 507 for Shirley Muxworth and Emily Robertson, 2, Melissa Thompson and Tara Benson's net 345. Well, Michael?
Oh, well, what can you say? 507 for Shirley and Emily, that's just fantastic work. Not much more you can say about that, couldn't miss.
Not too much at all. Sarah and Melissa just really didn't quite get on track after missing a couple of early spares.
Yeah, it makes it a bit hard when you've got Shirley going off like a hare after the tortoise, or is it the other way around? I'm not too sure. But after missing a couple of early frames, it makes it very hard to catch up after the start they had. Yeah,
that's right. And Emily and Shirley really, they started strong, and when Melissa and Sarah missed a couple of spares, they just grew in confidence. You just see their body language improving all the time. They were relaxed, they were chatty, they were having fun. In a doubles, how important is that?
Oh, it's so important. It's almost critical to be enjoying what you're doing out there, to have a good doubles team member, to be making your strikes and your spares. It's absolutely critical. And then, you know, you start mounting the pressure on the opposition. They start dropping a frame or two, and then it's a snowball effect, really.
Absolutely. And as we were talking about before, the amateur player as such, the handicap player bowling with the scratch player, the scratch player's personality was obviously going to have a hell of an effect on how the amateur player performs.
Yeah, it does. Like I say, it's important to have a scratch partner that is compatible, shows a good body language. You know, even if herself is not having such a good game, you know, it's just keep your chin up, keep going, get the pins.
Absolutely. Well, that's all for this week at the VIC 150. We will be back next week with another match from myself and Michael Tran. Good night from the Tenpin Bowling Show.
Good night.
The Bowling Show. Show was proudly presented by your local ABPA, Gold Pin and AMF Tenpin Bowling Centres.